There is a world all around us that we simply can't see. But what if we could explore beyond the limits of our senses? Let's slow down time. Fix your gaze. Reveal the unseen. And don't blink.
I never thought that I would be as passionate or interested as I've become. The more that you get to know them, you start to have a different perspective. I can stare at it and I find it fascinating, almost beautiful.
Mosquitoes, they go through, relatively speaking, four stages. Because they have eggs, and they hatch out of those into what we call larvae. If you're in a pond of stinky water, you see little wigglers, that's actually probably mosquito larvae. They actually just wiggle and float on the surface because they don't have gills. They actually have a little siphon on the back of them that they stick near the water surface, and they use that to breathe. After they do that, they actually then molt into a pupa, which floats at the surface. It looks like a little black comma. And then from that, once they've actually metamorphosized or changed inside to an adult mosquito, internal pressure will crack open the pupa, and then they'll emerge as an adult.
There are thousands of species of mosquito. They're really strikingly beautiful, actually. And only a very few hundred are potentially transmitting diseases to humans. And so obviously we've got thousands of other species out there that have no impact on us whatsoever. And instead, they're serving as food for other aquatic organisms when they're in the larval stage. And they're absolutely essential, that huge biomass of mosquitoes.
Box down.
Lights.
We're filming a mosquito taking off from a leaf. The size of our frame is about a centimeter across, but the amount of light that we need to film this because of the intense magnification and the really incredibly high frame rates, it's like two or three times the strength of the sun. So much so that whatever we put on our stage to film, it ignites, it literally burns. So we're having to think of weird and wonderful ways of keeping our leaves and insects alive, but also trying to get enough light into the set to see something.
The reason why we have a tent is because the mosquitoes have to remain contained at all times.
What we're mostly worried about is having them escape containment and breed a population in nature. So we're going through every measure we can to make sure they don't get out.
We've been volunteering our blood. We're just trying to shoot a bite sequence. The hardest thing is staying still, like absolutely still. Breath, twitching. Like any involuntary muscle motion just throws the whole shot completely off.
To be honest, some of the shots have been fascinating. You can watch a mosquito fill up with blood, but seeing it at such a, at the macro level, to actually watch them work that close, has been absolutely beautiful.